So what exactly is employee engagement? Why should you care about it? Let's start by looking at what your organization is trying to achieve. Success. Success is defined by your organization's business goals and targets. Core values are also important, since these guide how you reach your goals. To stay competitive, your organization needs individuals who are willing and able to perform at the highest levels, to apply discretionary effort, to provide maximum contribution. This is not something you can mandate, and it's not easy, but it's only one half of what we call the engagement equation. Individuals are on a separate path toward their own unique definitions of success at work, shaped by their personal values, interests, career aspirations, and work-life needs. They might describe this as higher compensation, professional growth, or better work-life balance. But unlike the organization's success, there is no one definition. All individuals are looking for work that works for them personally. We call that maximum satisfaction. Now, when I say individuals, I mean everyone: executives, managers, and individual contributors. They are all pursuing their unique definitions of success. So the organization is pursuing its definition of success, and individuals are pursuing theirs. These two paths intersect daily at a place we call the job. We define full engagement as the intersection of maximum contribution for the organization and maximum satisfaction for the individual. This is the apex in our model, a sustainable level of high performance that benefits both parties. The people in the apex are giving and getting at the highest levels possible. We call this group the engaged. Of course, on any day, as we look across any organization, not everyone is at the apex. There is a wide distribution in terms of satisfaction and contribution. For example, high performers are on one end, and people who aren't delivering much or working ineffectively are on the other. Some people are experiencing high satisfaction but aren't contributing fully. They may be new to the organization or new to a role and not fully productive, or working hard but on the wrong things, or simply content with lower levels of contribution. We call this group the satisfied and not contributing. On the opposite side of the model, we have the individuals who are delivering great results but not getting what they want from work. We call this group the contributing and not satisfied. You need to pay close attention to this group. Clearly, their high performance needs to be sustained for the organization to succeed. But when left unattended, these individuals usually find one of two exits. They might quit at a great known cost to the organization, or they might simply quit and stay, pulling back their efforts and drifting into the lower part of the model. Here, they join the disengaged, low on satisfaction and contribution, where no one is getting what they need from the relationship. Here, the partnership between the organization and the individual is clearly in need of a fix before their attitudes and behaviors become contagious. So, what about the people in the center? This is an important group we refer to as the almost engaged. They are important because they tend to be a large part of the workforce, reasonably satisfied and doing a decent job. They experience great days at work, but not consistently. They are more likely to consider a new employer than the fully engaged. And because they are solid performers, managers may focus their attention and coaching efforts elsewhere. The challenge for your organization is managing this dynamic. How can you align individuals to your need for maximum contribution while at the same time supporting individual employees' paths to personal success at work? It's a challenge you can't solve with a survey or a few organization-wide initiatives. And this is not a job for executives and managers alone. Everyone must play a role.